welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to the Positive Family, all about positivity. I'm your grandma Blibine. Welcome back to the channel. Guys, I just want to let you know that this lockdown, this self-isolation, this quarantine, this social distancing thing has not made me any boring. Oh, has not made me... Well, maybe a little bit bored because I'm used to being with my friend the whole time in my room. But then she's not around now. She went home. So you can imagine that I'm super bored without her. I miss her so much. Actually, I miss both of my friends, but we move, okay? We move. So today in the channel, I have something fun. You know, actually, I'm thinking that this lockdown, this self-quara-quara, like, it has made me think of this YouTube channel, not in a different way, but like, in a kind of fun way, and not very serious, very, you know, because we're trying to not be bored in this time, we're trying to have fun at the same time, we're trying to be informed as well, you know, I'm trying to bring, like, the fun element into the situation and not be boring and add more like thinking serious stuff on top of whatever is happening. So I'm trying to be very exciting, I'm trying to be very fun as I can. So I have another interesting video again today. So as you can tell by the title of the video, I am going to be doing my makeup for the first time in my life. Okay, I have done makeup, but my friend usually does it for me. Like, Nakona, it was just once or twice, if I'm not mistaken, that she has done my makeup. And yeah, she's good. She's still learning also, but she's good. She's quite good, okay? So now today, I'm gonna be doing my own makeup for the first time. Okay, so disclaimer, clarification, whatever. This is not a beauty channel. Okay, it's not a beauty channel. I'm not going to be talking about beauty and whatever. No, that's not my thing. That's not my type of coffee. Okay, so I'm a health person, lifestyle, but I'm not like a beauty person, so I'm not going to be doing beauty in this channel. But I thought, like, why not like do this thing. It's going to be exciting, it's going to be very fun, like filming this video and actually see myself in makeup that is done by me for the first time. It's gonna be very fun, and I'm excited to be sharing with you guys. You know, I'm very happy to be sharing with you guys because you guys are my family now. You know, whatever I do, I share with you. Okay, so yeah, I'll be doing my makeup for the very first time today, and I thought, why not add a bit of story time while I'm doing my makeup, like they do, like the YouTubers do, you know. So let's start. Okay, so I'm gonna be looking here, like, because I don't have a mirror. The mirror is in the bathroom, and I'm not a makeup person, and I don't see my friend's mirror. So, by the way, I borrowed makeup from my friend. Okay, I borrowed makeup from my friend. So yo, I've watched the tutorials, okay, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to do this. But what's so hard, you know? I've been watching makeup tutorials, you know, I've been like, what's so hard? Okay, so yes, I'm gonna show you what I have. This is so funny. I'm gonna show you what I have. So I have the Signature Extra Cover Foundation Natural Look Moisturizer Lightweight and Don't Tone. This is it. Ooh, like a YouTuber. This is it. Okay. And this is another foundation, the Signature Extra Cover Stick. So this is like this. So I think I'm gonna be using this one, because this one, like, you, how do you open this? Yeah, that type of moment. Okay, I have mascara. It's the Ifudia waterproof mascara. Yo, it's about to be lit. I think this is an eyeshadow palette. I think this is an eyeshadow palette. It is. Why is it? Oh god. This is an eyeshadow palette. Okay, I think it is. What's the difference between a contour palette and an eyeshadow palette? I don't know, but this is a eyeshadow palette. This is also an eyeshadow palette because it's written eye quads. So this is also an eyeshadow palette, I assume. This is Fenty Matte lipstick. I bought this last year because I thought I was gonna this one is mine because I bought it. But I never use it, mind you. I never use it lipstick on my lips. I use your lip balms, your Vaseline, your wigs, you know, lip glosses, but I don't use lipstick. So yeah, this is the Beauty Blender. These are the brushes. I have no idea what these are for. What these are for, I have no idea, but we can see. Okay. We have powder. It's a bit dusty, but you get the drill, okay? We have the palette. And we have my Labello that I used. I think I'm gonna use this instead of lipstick. We'll see. We'll see where we get with this thing. Yeah, that's about it. That's what I have. I don't have a, let's see. Oh, we have a baby here. I think this is a lipstick. Liquid lipstick. Okay. We have this as well. We'll see what I use, okay guys? So let's start. But I don't know how to do makeup. I've never done makeup before, so, and I watched tutorials, but I'm not sure. Okay, so what I'll be doing is I'm gonna be playing a video here on my laptop, and I'm gonna be looking at what she is doing, and I'm gonna be copying what she's doing. I'm gonna be copying it. Ah, this is about to be fun. I'm gonna be copying what she's doing. And yeah, let's get on with the video. So yeah, I'll be looking at you guys like at my screen because I don't have a mirror, and I'll also be looking at her to see what she does, and then I'm gonna do it. And in the meantime, at the same time be telling you a story which I think you're about to be interested in. Okay, let's start. So let me just play and watch what she does, and then let me do it. Yo guys, this looks a bit hard. She's doing her eyebrows, y'all. I don't know how to do eyebrows. I don't think I'm gonna do eyebrows. Let's see if this mascara is not. I'm gonna try to brush my eyebrows with this thing. Let's see. Yo, I feel like my Charlene Damase, okay? Okay, she started with her eyebrows. She brushed them like this. I don't know if I'm doing it correctly, but I was thinking of not like doing my eyebrows because they need to be shaved or trimmed, like for them to be like proper, but there's no one to do that for me, and the salons are not open. So we're gonna work with what we have, okay? Okay, so let's see. So yeah guys, the story. So I joined Tinder. I know, I joined Tinder last year in April. Ukupapa. Wizu kupapa. Kupapa uli munyani joining bo Tinder. What the hell? Like, I joined Tinder, y'all. I joined Tinder. And it was fun, you know, at the beginning, like, joining Tinder. It was very fun. Like, you get to meet different men, you know, who with different characteristics and whatever. I'm embarrassed to be telling you the story, but we're done with embarrassment, feeling embarrassed and stuff. Like, we old now, okay? We old. Why is this thing not working? Okay. But yeah, I joined Tinder. It was all fun and games, like, at the beginning when I started joining it, because, like, I had no boyfriend that time, you know. And then I wanted to, and then I was like, okay, since I have no one, your luck. Since I have no one, no boyfriend, and like all my friends had boyfriends, and I was bored because, like, I was in a relationship before, so it's not like I was new into this thing, and I think it didn't matter, you know. My eyebrows, ooh, honey, you know. Basha, but how say it's a drama? Shia, literally. Let me rinse this thing off. So yeah, as I was saying, so like I was in a relationship before, like my first with my first boyfriend in first year and whatever. So when we broke up, I had no one, and so like it started getting to me that, oh, I'm lonely or whatever. And honestly, I didn't know what I was saying. Okay, I didn't know what I was saying, cause it's so nice being single. It is so nice. So nice, like, say to my skin, it's looking a bit nice, but we're not there, okay? So yeah, I'm gonna go in with my foundation now. So like I was kind of in a stage, going through a stage, let me open this. I was going through a stage of like, all right, all right, my friends are in a relationship and I'm left alone, and you know, that type of stuff. So I joined Tinder. Was it not fun? It was very fun, guys. It was very fun. And like I was going on these, like, all these kind of dates and nice dates, being taken out and whatever, you know. So like it was nice, it was very fun, until my girlfriend found someone who they really connected with, and the person was not on the same page. Okay, he was not on the same page, and he tricked me into believing that he was on the same page. Okay, like, we were like, well, we weren't serious at the beginning, you know, and I believed that it was okay. It was hookup thing, you know, and I believe him, you know, that it was hookup thing, until I visited the guy. Oh, child. Until I visited the guy, and it was not the same anymore. It was not the same anymore, because now we were having fun. I don't want to look like a ghost, yeah. Because we were having fun with the guy, ne? Me and the guy were having fun. You know, he was a good guy, like, a bit older and mature than me, you know. Mind you, last year I was 20 on the dot, like, because this year I'm turning 21, so it's very young to be thinking that someone is mature. Like, I was very young to be thinking that someone is mature and we get serious and whatever. So so I did with the guy. We didn't go out even. Like, I visited him at his place, ne? Today we started like chatting, chilling, and whatever. We hooked up and whatever. Nah, it was nice. It was nice that, oh, y'all. It was nice that time. Mm. And still, until like when we like hung out more often, and then he started saying things like he's serious and whatnot. Yo, I'm not gonna be looking at the girl anymore because she has your concealers and whatnot. I don't have those, so I'm gonna be like, what is it? Freestyling, kind of like just make it on my own, you know. I'm gonna just freestyle it and write it the way like I think should go. So if I look horrible, then yeah. So I saw them doing even on the neck, so I'm gonna do even on the neck. So yeah, me and the guy was vibing. We were vibing, and yeah, and so like he started talking things of seriousness and whatever, you know. I know why, but he did, you know. He made me believe that he wanted to be with me for the long run and not just for now, okay. And I really like he played me, he did play me. And yeah, I believe that he loved me and whatever. Kantimo guy, no, he's not on the same page as I am. Okay, he's not on the same page as I am. Okay, so like we started hooking up. Hooking up means sex was involved, okay? So yeah. And then yeah. And then we started hooking up and whatever. We chilled. I told him about my status. He said he was okay with it, and okay, it was like a bonus for me. It was like a bonus for me. I keep going in with this foundation, eh? And keep putting your power. I think this is enough. Okay, so he was like, nah, I'm cool with it, it's fine. And then that's when I started believing him, you know, like being naive, because I was like, nah, no one is gonna love me with this status, with this HIV status. So like whoever accepts me, like I pretty much think we're gonna die together, or he's the one, whatever. So that's how naive I was. Then it came a guy, like I started getting attached, obviously, you know, to the guy. And then the second last time we saw each other, I was going home the next Saturday. Okay, so I went to him, yeah, I saw him and then went back home. He was used to like talking to me, but not too much. Like, because I was like this naive person, I didn't see that he didn't like me. So he was talking to me, magetala, always me trying to thingy. Hey, it's going to be. Oh wait, ooh! Ciao. It's dusted off, okay? It's too much. So it was always me trying to like talk to him. Guys, halaka bona mukele tango ting doze. Dusty. Okay, so it was always him trying to make us talk, because like, you know, trying to be the older girl here, which I wasn't. And I was in a way that I was gonna be played, like I was being like taken for a ride, you know. So he didn't text me for that whole weekend I was at home. So I was like okay cool, you don't text me, all right? Because I was thinking like we're in this together, like we were in a relationship kind of thing. I was in that zone. I knew we were hooking up, but like at the same time, I don't know, because of the things that he always said, I was thinking, ah, he's in love with me, this guy. Yeah, he can't live without me. Yeah, he can't. Mugele, way poor. Yeah, but Mara, it's not bad. Okay, so it happened, or like, nah, I came back. When I came back, I texted the guy. I was like, bruh. And then you don't text me the whole weekend. And he was like, I was busy, my friend was going through some stuff. He needed me more than he knew. He needed me more than anything, and that's why I was out. And I was like, yo, okay, friends come first, we get that. Right. Even with me, my friends come first, but like at least call the girl and tell the girl, Gucci, nah, my friend is going through some stuff, and you know, I can't be talking to you. I'll talk to you when you get back to Joburg and whatever. No, he didn't do that, Muka. He just kept quiet. So then I started, I was like, I started asking him now, being the on confrontation and all that stuff, and started asking him, Gandhi, what do you want? What do you want? What is happening between us? He was like, nah, I'm not sure, but I'm not sure what I want. Mind you. You should get your things straight. Like, nah. If he's watching this, I'm sorry, but that's how I feel. That's how you made me feel, okay? Boo boo, okay. And then he was like, he was not sure what he wants and whatever. So, right. I was like, okay. If you're not sure what you want, then I'm not trying to be with you, because I know what I want, and I want you, and I don't want us to be just friends. I want more. I get, I was trying to be old and like ever, if you like those type of thing of, if you're not girlfriending me, that, but like it's true, if you're not gonna girlfriend me, why you think you're gonna get it? You're gonna get it, okay? I don't make friends with guys. Well, I do make friends with guys, but make it clear from the beginning that you want to be friends and not friends with benefits, because I don't do friends with benefits. I'm sorry. No? So he said that, Miguel started losing interest. I started crying for the guy and feeling all kind of depressed. My friends know all about it. I started being like all depressed over the guy because now we didn't talk. Ooh, my chair starting to feel. Let me fix this chair. We started being all with the guy. He started being all silent on me, and I was like, okay. If that's what the guy's gonna do, he gonna do me like this, then yeah. Then I wasn't up for it, you know. I wasn't really up for it. So he called me after like I think 2 days and said to me, so I'm gonna go in with my eyeshadow palette now. Ooh, this part. Do you think I should put it here? On top of the eyes. I think I'm gonna try that. Let's see. Should eyeshadow go here or here only? This is when English comes in. Never mind. So I said I'm gonna freestyle it. Let me freestyle it. So he called me later, like after 2 days, and said to me, now Winnie, I don't want to lose you, but at the same time, I'm not ready for a relationship, but I don't want to lose you. And I was like, bruh, I ain't trying to be your friend, just your friend. I'm so sorry, and I ain't trying to be just your friend. So guys, I'm back. My battery died, so I had to do the things. I had to plug in my phone. So yeah, where was I? I was about to apply my thing. My eyeshadow palette, and I was saying that I told the guy that, nah, I'm not trying to be just your friend. I'm not trying to just be a friend. I want to be more than that. I want to be more than that, and I think you should, like, I don't know what you want. Just, I think you should tell me what you want. And he was like, nah, I don't want to lose you, but at the same time, this is not right. But it doesn't look like I'm applying anything. But at the same time, I don't want to lose you, but at the same time, I'm not ready for a relationship. I was like, nah, if you're not ready, stay like that. So that's when me and the guy stopped talking. Stopped talking, and the guy stopped talking for that time. And then later in life, because me being a girl that I am, I contacted the guy and started telling him how I feel, blah blah blah, and if he doesn't want to be in a relationship, it's fine, we can just hook up, yabo, and I'm fine with us just hooking up. And then the guy was like, what am I doing, Winnie? And the guy was like, okay, fine. We did hooks up for like, I think 2 times before we cut ties forever. So yeah, we did cut ties forever. We don't talk anymore. But like sometimes when I remember all the times we shared, the great memories we had together, you know, I'm like, bruh, like I'm like, Father God, antina komu yang that haki kray monna. Like once I think that kim krayli, alrighty, then wow. You say no, girl. My face. You say no, girl. This ain't yours. He ain't yours. So, like, and now I understand that if something is not yours, it's not yours. I'm trying to do different colors. See, it's not working. And I was like, no. Father God was like, no, girl. If something ain't yours. Okay, so stop forcing things. Stop forcing things and stop like trying to like compare yourself with other people who has their lives in control and intact and whatever, because your time is coming and your destiny is not their destiny. Like, y'all are not destined for the same things. Okay, so I should, what's this for? So I should, I don't know what's this for. So I should accept that actually other people have their lives. Like, their lives are like fine now, and I shouldn't be trying to compare with them. So my future husband, I'm waiting for you, okay? Mama Bear is waiting for you, and you're gonna take your time. And I will be waiting for you. So, like, what I'm trying to tell you is that, what I'm trying to tell y'all is that, what I'm trying to tell y'all is that, like, don't rush into things. Yeah, bro. Don't rush into things because, like, the Lord has His timing for everything. He has His timing for everything, and His timing is always perfect. You know, His timing is always perfect, and His timing is not your timing. So if you want a boyfriend now, He ain't giving the boyfriend to you. Accept it, baby girl. Okay, no, accept it, baby girl. Accept that the Lord doesn't feel that you're ready. The Lord doesn't feel that you're ready for that right now. You should accept that, man, and not try to do things your way, because you might end up being hurt in the process. That's what I learned, you know. That's what I learned. And yeah, I'm still on Tinder. Well, I delete and put it back on every time I'm bored. Okay, so I'm still on Tinder. I don't know why I'm still there. Maybe it's just to meet like new people now, and I'm not rushed into anything. Whatever happens, happens. Though I want a serious relationship, but if it doesn't, if it's not happening, it's not happening, and I shouldn't be trying to force it. And I shouldn't be trying to force it, because I will end up being hurt. Okay, so let's apply mascara now. I think I'm done with my, well, it looks pretty beginner, and I've never applied mascara myself too, so I don't know how to do this. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to tell you guys, that Wash out for Tinder, wash out. And I have experience, and I, even if I'm there, I have experience, you know, you get to see those guys who are there just for playing, just to hooks up, and those that are, because most of them are just there to hook up. Most of them are just there to hook up. Ooh. Oh, do you have eyelashes this long? Most of them are just there to hook up and not for something serious. So be careful, watch out for them. And take care of yourself. These things, these platforms are not like, are not safe, you know, not safe. I've met like people who are like monsters, pretty much. Like, I've met so many people. I met monsters, I met good people, I met players, I met people who are serious, and like, you just don't connect. And it's okay, all right, it's okay. Not everyone you meet there's gonna be a good person. And everyone you meet is gonna be a good person, so yes guys, yes y'all, I'm almost done with my makeup. But I think here, kicking a little bit, I'll just go on again with the, eyeshadow on top. Ebo? Oh, girl, you look horrible. No, you look beautiful. Ebo? So, yeah. I think this is, yeah, I'm fine. I wish I had like digital to my eyebrow and your eyebrow pencil. I'm Eva. Nikishapa eyebrow. Yanu, gahutirsa what I have, okay? Gahutirsa what I have. But I think I shouldn't be going with thingy. Because I don't have concealer, that's the thing. I would like go over my eyebrows like this, but yeah, so that's what I'm saying, y'all. Like, be careful on these like dating platforms. I've been on a lot of them, I'll tell you, a lot of them. I'm not trying to mention like other sites, whatever, because out of some of them I forgot, but I've been on a lot of them. I've met people, and I'm sorry, mama, if you're gonna be watching this someday and you're like my girl, and I'm actually disappointing. I'm not disappointing, you know, sometimes you explore in life, like you're just trying to explore life your own way, your way, and trying to see things, you know, your way, and without like influences from other people and whatnot. So that's what I think I'm gonna go on with this lipstick, with this Revlon Color Stay Ultimate Liquid Lipstick. So yeah, I was also doing the same. I was trying to see what life has for me. So I was trying to see what life has for me without, like, of course parents are there to guide you, parents are there to, yeah, to advise you, but sometimes you just need to figure out some things on your own. And I did just that. Like, we all had our fair shares of ups and downs, and those were my shares of downs, where I thought I could find love in a dating site, which is possible. People have found love on Tinder and marriages, but it's not for everyone, if you get what I'm saying. So yeah, that's my story with the guy I found on Tinder, and I believe that we were legit, actually. But nah, I'm still on Tinder, mind you. You know, you never know when you might get your one. So I think I'm done, y'all, with my makeup. How do I look? Be honest. How do I look? Let me. Well, I don't look perfect, but I tried. Okay, I tried. Tried. I think I mixed. I tried, y'all. I tried. Just like, let me look closer, so y'all can see what I did. Kanti, don't you? So y'all can see what I did right there. It's a bit sticky. Oh, is it how it's supposed to be? My lips are very dark, girl. So like, so I'm done. This is my first time applying my own makeup, and this is the look that I went for. And I don't know if I did it correctly or I did not, but I was learning. It was my learning time, and I did pretty well for a beginner. Well, I think so. At least I think I did pretty well for a beginner. So yes, guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope it made you laugh. I hope it made you laugh. I hope you had a good time watching me doing my makeup for the first time on camera. For the first time in my life, and for the first time also on camera. Like, for the first time for everybody. You see, so yeah, I hope you also enjoyed my story time. I hope you learned something from it, from my story. Yeah, so please like the video if you liked it. Please like the video, please give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And yes, I will see you in a before. Please comment, like, and subscribe to my channel. Let's just be positive. Let's wash our hands. I'm gonna wash my hands after this. Let's wash our hands. Let's keep clean. And yeah, like, we're gonna fight this together, guys. Stay home, stay positive. All right, so until next time, see you in my next one. Bye. Peace.